Welcome to my channel, I'm Gary Wiryawan, and I just bought the new Sony A7C. No, I'm just kidding, this is not the Sony A7C, and we're gonna talk about it in this video, let's go! Before we continue with today's video, this is just a quick reminder for you to support my channel by liking this video, sharing this video, and subscribing to my channel down below. Thank you, and let's continue with the video. So if you are a subscriber of my channel and you already watched some of my old videos, you might already recognize what camera is this. This is not the new Sony A7C. This is actually a Panasonic camera, a Panasonic GX8 from 2015. However, this camera looks a lot like the new Sony A7C. In my personal opinion. However, I really enjoy using this camera and I'm still using it right now for my personal need. Apart from the similar physical look of the camera body, I think between the GX8 and the Sony A7C, there are lots of other similarities as well in my personal opinion. And I will share those similarities with you in this video. And that leads to the whole point of why I'm making this video, which is, spoiler alert, to tell you guys that you don't always need a new camera. So let me quickly go over some key specifications of the Panasonic GX8 and I will compare it with the Sony A7C. First, the Panasonic GX8 has the 20 megapixel new Micro Four Thirds sensor that is exactly the same as the one inside Panasonic GH5. The Sony Alpha 7C has 24 megapixel sensor, which is 4 megapixel more than this. It is significant, but it's not too far. This Panasonic GX8 also has weatherproof body, which I think the Sony A7C also has. Combined with a weather sealed lens, the combination of a weather sealed body and lens will allow you to shoot during bad weather conditions. This Panasonic GX8 also has the tilty flippy screen, which I think the Sony A7C also has. Both the Panasonic GX8 and the Sony A7C has in-body image stabilizer built into the sensor, so it's easier to shoot photo and video using unstabilized lens. Both of these cameras also shoots 4K video up to 30 frames per second. Both cameras also has about 10 frames per second of continuous burst shooting. And both cameras also has built-in electronic viewfinder. Obviously, it goes without saying that the Panasonic GX8 is a Micro Four Thirds camera and the Sony A7C is a full frame camera. They are very different and their difference is very significant. That means you cannot really compare between these two cameras.
Or can you?
Even if the Panasonic GX8 is only a Micro Four Thirds camera, I really love the camera so much. It's my personal favorite camera and it's been with me around the world to places such as Norway, Finland, Svalbard, Japan, Canada, New Zealand and so many other places. I bought this camera when it first came out in August 2015 and back then, it's my definition of my perfect camera and it still is my perfect camera in my opinion. The form factor, the controls, the easy to use, the snappiness, the reasonably good image quality, the ruggedness, and the capabilities of this camera is what makes me really enjoy using it as my primary photography camera. This camera can handle a lot of different demanding situations very easily and it performs very well for fast action photography, for wildlife photography, for street photography, for landscape photography, for wedding, and for so many other different kinds of photography. And ever since I got this camera with me, it really helps to slightly reduce the gear acquisition syndrome that I have in me, and now I become more immune to the advertising of new cameras. Well, I only say that it slightly reduces my gear acquisition syndrome, not completely. For example, I bought a new camera after the GX8, and that's the Panasonic G85, which is this camera that's currently recording this video right now, because it's now serving as my main primary video camera, while this is performing as my main photography camera. The reason why I need the G85 as my main video camera and not use the GX8 as both my photo and video camera is because it is lacking some important features that I need for video. So I can still use it for video uses, especially for shooting B-roll, and I can still get a good result, but it's not my main A-roll camera. And now that really leads to the main point of the video that I want to talk about to you guys. A few months ago, I was talking in one of my my videos about gear minimalism, basically I talk about why you shouldn't invest too much in gear. And today's video, I want to re-emphasize some of the important points that I talk about in that video while also bringing some new thoughts with this video. People are constantly being bombarded by marketing and advertising of new gear, be it new cameras, new lenses, and new accessories whatsoever. However, I honestly think that unless you are a true professional that's requiring a specific feature that could significantly improve your workflow or your quality, chances are you probably don't need a new gear. While you might actually not have all the gears that you want, you probably already have all the gears that you need. I mean, I won't lie to you, I am still tempted by so many new cameras and lenses and other gears that many manufacturers are advertising to us, including ones from Canon, Sony, Nikon, Fuji, and Panasonic. But then, in the end, I realize it's not about the gear, it's about you, it's about me as photographers, as videographers, as content creators. What are we doing with the tools that we already have? How are you able to utilize all the gears that you already have and try to make the most out of it? Learning new skills and techniques, practicing a difficult shooting technique, experimenting with something out of your comfort zone, all of this could be something that you really need right now to improve your result rather than a new camera or a new lens. Now, this does not mean that I am forbidding you from buying a new gear. I buy new gear too, all the time. And I also won't be the hypocrite that will tell you,
"Oh, I no longer have the gear acquisition syndrome. I just embrace the minimalism spirit."
That kind of nonsense. I'll be honest with you, a few weeks ago, I just bought this new gear myself, and it's this Rode VideoMic NTG that is currently recording this video right now. Honestly, there's nothing wrong with my old Rode Video Micro that I was using previously, and the NTG was purchased not completely because of necessity. But I personally just want something that makes my workflow easier and faster. I want a microphone that can be able to record directly inside my computer without any additional tool, and the NTG did just that. And as a bonus, the NTG has a slightly better sound quality when compared to the older Video Micro. However, enough talking about microphones, I really digress. So, the main point of the video that I wanna talk about to you is try to be more conscious and to be more honest when you make a decision to purchase a new gear. Don't just say yes to every kind of new gear that's on your wish list every time you have spare money left over. Ask yourself these questions if you are tempted with new gear. Do you really need this gear, and can your old gear cover what it does? Be honest to yourself and be more mindful about want versus need. So that is all for today's video. I hope that you find this video to be useful. Please let me know in the comments down below, what is the latest gear that is on your wish list, and are you going to buy it or not? Also, don't forget to support my channel by liking this video, sharing this video, and subscribing to my channel down below. Thank you and goodbye.